Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Okay, so in honor of this song, which is a Music Share Monday, first time we've been doing Meatloaf, we have not only the whiskey in the glass, but we've also got the water in the cup, because the first time I ever heard this song was the first time I ever got drunk.
Really?
First time ever. I was way too young to. We went over to a friend's house, and we didn't know how alcohol worked, and so he just poured out like 10 shots. We were like, took a bunch of shots, I don't know how many of each person, and we were just like, nothing happened.
So you're saying you were underage?
Yes. So we did that, and I had just broken up with a girl at the time.
Oh, so you were mad, bro. You were upset. Hurt.
I didn't know I was, but apparently drinking out brings out feelings. And so I remember being drunk, listening to this song on the floor, and being like, what? Because it's a breakup song, and it is so well written. So this is the only one I've heard from him. It's one of my mom's favorite artists.
Okay.
I know there's a lot more we could do. I know Bat Out of Hell is one my mom's talked about, Paradise by the Dashboard Lights.
Yeah.
But we figured start with this one and then let you guys decide where we move on from there.
I've never heard a single Meatloaf song ever. I have seen him featured in Tenacious D, The Pick of Destiny with Jack Black. The movie, he has a scene where he's like his dad, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
And so that's – I didn't even know it was him until I saw comments in the comment section where people were saying like that's where like we might know him from. And I was like, oh, crap, I do know him from there.
Yeah.
So first time hearing him.
Dude, so – different because it's definitely like a ballady thing. I think it's going to be similar to Chicago for you, where it's like still great songs, definitely a love song. Dude, so sad. Imagine being drunk the first time like hearing this. That's all I got to say. And with that, make sure you hit the subscribe button, comment down below, maybe the first time you heard the song, and maybe definitely another one that you think we should do. With that being said, let's get into it.
Nothing left inside of me. And maybe you can cry all night, but that'll never change the way that I feel. The snow is really piling up outside. I wish you
That's that song.
Damn, dude. Yeah. That was very heartfelt.
Dude, I know, right?
Like, that was coming straight from the soul, man.
It really hits you when it's, like, the first part of the song, and he's singing about, you know, telling this chick, he's like, I want you, I need you, but I'm just not going to love you. Like, I just don't. And yeah. It's like, man, that hurts a little. But then you get to the end of the song, and he's like, I can't give you something I've never got. And then he goes, ooh, this chick, the only person I've ever loved, said, I want you, I need you, but I just don't love you.
Damn, I didn't catch that in terms of, like, I didn't feel those, like, perspective shifts.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's what it was.
That definitely makes me think higher of the song. Not that I thought low of it before.
Yeah.
But that brings it up in terms of, like, how I'm looking at it.
Well, I'll tell you, listening back to it, because I haven't listened to it in a very long time.
Yeah.
And hearing it, I think it's sonically very well put together. But it's not throwing a ton of sauce out there. It is pretty straight ahead,
right,
with what it's doing, which is fine. It's not all over the place. But to me, as like, I think this is one of the first times I was like, wow, that's a well written song.
Really?
As far as like a concept or idea, like the idea of 2 out of 3 ain't bad, and yeah, how to do a turn of phrase like that. Like, that to me was the most impressive part of the song.
You know what he means by that? I don't think I got it.
So I want you.
Uh huh.
I need you, but I'm never going to love you. But don't be sad. Wow. 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
I didn't catch that. I'm very slow with shit like that.
Yeah. And you're a math guy too, so I don't know why that wouldn't.
Oh yeah, right.
Yeah.
Well, when you mix math with words, that's what things get kind of weird with me.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So here's what I'll tell you. So I like the song a lot. I think I'm gonna give this song a B+.
I think it's
and
fair.
The reason I'll tell you why is I liked it a lot. I think they could have accomplished, but this could change in terms of like now me hearing about the perspectives of how it kind of went around. But I feel like they could have accomplished the same thing just with like less words.
Yeah.
And a little less long. And not that I don't like long songs. I like long songs. I just felt like it was kind of like repeating itself a little bit too much for my taste. But maybe it's also because I'm not in the feeling of that.
Yeah.
You know, like I'm a very happy guy with a happy gal. So it's like things are going well. So I can't relate as much to it now.
Mm-hmm.
But I could see if I was, you know, little drinking a little bit in a sad kind of state.
Or if you just broken up. Imagine you just, because for me, it was like, and it was like not the first time. It wasn't I was like actually in love, but I was what I thought was love at like a 15-year-old or whatever.
Which you still feel it.
You still feel it in the moment. You're like, this is like, oh my gosh, I held her hand on the way to class. Like, what am I going to do
now? I kissed
her
cheek and everything.
I've given her everything I have. I gave her my milk the last 3 lunches. Like, I don't know what she wants. But so to have that mentality of it, and dude, it's a song whenever I think about it or listen back to it, I go, dude, I really hope this is not what anybody else is feeling, to like have them look back and be like, yeah, there was one girl I loved. That was a long time ago. She said this to me. And it's like, that's horrible.
Great voice, dude. It was not really what I was expecting whatsoever. Because just from like, we pulled them up on Spotify and I saw just like the image of the band and like their backing photo.
Yeah.
And I was expecting something completely different. You know
he
I mean?
Looks like meat. He looks like a meatloaf. He doesn't sing like a meatloaf.
That's a really good way to put that.
Yeah.
No, beautiful voice, dude.
Beautiful voice. Now, the way, to my understanding, from what people have explained to me, is that he was the main singer and there was somebody else doing the writing and the that sort of stuff, like both the lyrics and the melodies, but he was not a good singer, so he was like, I need somebody else to sing this. So kind of like, I guess I'm thinking of like Boston in the same sort of mentality, which is cool. It's like a writing duo and a singer. He's a great singer. I think he conveys emotion really well. I think there's still, now that I'm listening back to it, like a little too much emphasis on some words for me that like killed it for me from what it used to be. Still think it's a great song. I think you're probably right, B+.
I just think I dig the feeling a lot. Mm-hmm. I just feel like it could have been more like emphasized and impactful, and like it would have stuck with me more if it was a little shorter, so it felt more special. Because I feel like not that it lost its novelty, but just like when you're getting towards the end, it's like, all right. Especially when you have, I think the peak of the song was around the middle point, where most songs, they have like that peak or that kind of big dynamic shift upward around maybe the 65-75% mark. But they did it right around the halfway point, at least it felt like it.
Yeah.
So then you have the whole other half of the song where it's kind of just going down in dynamic.
Well, for me, it's a storyline song, right?
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, my biggest thing, I'm not a huge fan of the verses of this song. Mm-hmm. I'm more a fan of the idea of the chorus.
Mm.
And so I like how the whole thing sounds sonically, but idea-wise, it's like I really care about the lyrics that are happening in the chorus. I care about the storyline, like the way they set it up, but they didn't set it up in a way that I like is super memorable and palpable for me.
I think the songwriting on this is impeccable. It was more so just like the execution, some decisions in terms of
what
like,
I think
length.
It is, dude. I think it's a perfectly written song on paper.
Yeah, but I think a poem of this, like just the lyrics, boom.
Yeah,
keep going.
But I think At least for me, even though it's like a perfectly written song on paper, like stuff like in the bridge, it talks about you'll never drill for oil on a sandy beach. You'll never or you'll never find your gold on a sandy beach. You'll never dig for oil on a city street.
Yeah.
Something like that. Like it has all these like analogies that I think are very well put together on paper. But to me, it's like, is that the way that I actually think about love? Not really. Like, even though that's super well written, I think sometimes when you have a not as good songwriter, and I'm going to like,
people in the comments, well, you're young, that's why. You just wait.
Maybe. I mean, it hit me hard as like a 15-year-old. I feel like he definitely is a great writer. I think it's the difference between like C.S. Lewis and Robert Frost.
Yeah.
You know, it's like one is simple and it's like, poof, that hits home. And then C.S. Lewis, it's like,
because you don't have to think too hard about it. You don't like to digest it. You don't have to like go too hard into it. Kind of, it's very simple. Whereas like some like complex lines, like they might hit you harder if you like do the work. But sometimes the simpler lines, you don't have to do the work
like,
for them.
There's a lyric better. In that same bridge. There ain't no Coupe de Ville hiding at the bottom of a Cracker Jack box. Like, it's a cool line, but it's a lot there. It's
a lot of words in terms of like trying to represent the feeling that you're trying to create.
Yeah.
But, you know.
So either way, really good. I love like the bass that it plays in it. Like, that's one of the things that I noticed here.
The first 5 seconds, that's what sold me on. Like, I was like, oh, this is going to be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I think B+ is fair. I like it. Want to hear some more of it. Want to hear his other stuff, because I know he does rockery type stuff.
Yeah. So, I mean, let us know. This is the only one I've ever heard, so we want to start with this. That way we're both fresh. With that being said, I guess we'll see you next week. Leave that, Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Yeah, we'll see you Wednesday. Leave it in the comments what we should do next.
Peace out. Oh, the Meatloaf fans don't get mad at us.